Our first topic today is regarding getting the call right. We are going to talk quite a bit about this topic today because it is felt that we are not handling this rule consistently across the country as it was meant to be enforced. Let's first remember that any calling official can go for help to one of his partners at most any time. The only calls that cannot be reversed are calls such as a catch-no-catch with multiple runners on base, unless there are two outs and you're changing a no-catch to a catch. As the non-calling official, there are only 7 instances when you can come to the calling official unsolicited and offer input, and those are all listed in Appendix E in the back of the rulebook. Our focus today is going to be on the calling official and when this official should or should not go for help. We are seeing a growing trend across the country of calling officials going for help way too often, mostly just to pacify an upset coach. Although there are times when you certainly need to go for help as the calling official, there are also times that you shouldn't. When you are 100%, I repeat 100% sure that you have gotten the call correct, you should not go for help. If you have a tough call to make and you know that you are the only official on the field that could actually see the call, you should not go for help just to pacify an upset coach. Stand your ground. Examples of this would be if the pitch hit the batter's hand or the end of the bat. You know that your partners are 90 plus feet away and will not be able to know what the ball hit. Situations such as this require you to slow down, take your time, read all the elements of the play, and then make your decision. On plays such as a hit batter, if you feel that you clearly missed a critical element of the play, then by all means, you should need to go for help. Let's look at a few video clips now and try to implement what we just said. I will let each of the clips play through one time and let you decide how you would handle, and then we'll go back through together a second time. Now that you've had an opportunity to watch this clip, let's talk about a few things regarding this situation. First, there is no doubt in my mind that this umpire got this call correct. I would also bet that this umpire knows that he got the call correct. I thought the umpire used very good mechanics and came up very clearly and strong with his decision. I realize that this is the finals of the College World Series, but there's no reason for this umpire to go for help on this play. As a staff, we feel that this umpire would be best served in this situation to tell the coach that he was 100% certain that he got the call correct and he is not going to go for help. Stand your ground. Lastly, many of these types of situations, you know as an umpire that your crew is not going to have any better look at this from 90 feet away than you did. Often they can't tell at all. Our decision as an NCAA staff for this clip is that this umpire got the call correct and should not have gone for help. Thank you. This next clip can be very difficult for an umpire to judge. We feel as a staff that this umpire needs to stand his ground and make the decision on this type of play. This is a very difficult play for this umpire to put the onus on his partners that are 90 plus feet away. It is felt that your crew on a play like this is not going to be able to offer any additional information in helping to get this call correct. If for some reason the catcher blocked the umpire out from seeing this, then the umpire may elect to go for help. Our decision as an NCAA staff for this clip is that the home plate umpire had the best look at this play, knows that his partners really won't be able to offer any additional help, and therefore should not have gone for help. Now, this play is a little bit different. For those of us watching the video, we can tell that the umpire did miss this initial call. I think we all would agree on this play that the umpire was not 100% certain as to whether he got the call correct or not. For me, when I watch the umpire's reaction to this play, I feel that he is unsure as to whether he got the call correct. We can see the umpire flinch a bit as the ball crosses the plate. Watch very closely. Did the catcher's head move between the ball and the umpire's eyes? Either way, I would say on this call that the umpire got blocked out and or missed a very crucial element to this play. As a staff, we feel that the umpire did the right thing on this play and did seek help from his partners. One final note, when we do go for help, make sure the entire crew gets together. Here is another play that happened last season during the NCAA postseason. The first thing you need to know with this play is that there were two outs before the ball was hit. This was a very tough decision for the third base umpire to make as to whether it was a catch or not. Video replays were not conclusive, which tells you how close of a call it really was. The third base umpire should have the best angle when making a judgment on this play. The second base umpire is on the second base side of the infield, and the home plate umpire would be looking straight through this play with little or no angle to make a judgment. By rule, the crew can change this from a no catch to a catch. With two outs, there'd be no problem placing runners. The inning would be over with no run scoring. I thought the crew did a good job getting together on this play. They each took the time to evaluate what was seen, and it appears that no one on the field had any better look at the play or any additional information to add than what the third base umpire originally had. As an NCAA staff, we have decided that this crew did the right thing by getting together. Although the call was not reversed, the crew had every right to change this to a catch if they felt the call was missed. Another tough call by the umpires to make. The question in this video is whether the ball first hit above or below the yellow line. It is difficult to tell if the ball hit the wall twice, first above the yellow line, and then if it hit a second time below the line. One mechanical note that should be pointed out in this video is that the second base umpire started out on the left field side of second base. We would prefer this umpire in this situation to go ahead and stay to the left field side to help further develop an angle rather than trying to run across the angle to the other side of the center fielder. Yes, there were two outs on this play. Could this crew have changed this call from a no catch to a home run? The answer, as interpreted by the NCAA Secretary Rules Editor Jim Pirano, is yes. With the same theory as changing a no catch to a catch with two outs, in this clip, by changing the play to a home run, the placement of the runner or runners is obvious, and no further problems would exist by changing this call.